All right. Another question we get asked a lot is about Magic the Gathering and if it's dangerous or if it's okay. This actually it depends more on the intention of the people that you're playing with. In the game, after all, is spelled MAGIC. Remember that Aleister Crowley originated spelling magic, satanic magic, ending with a K. And magic ending with a C is generally like a child's birthday party magic or Doug Henning or something like that, something fairly innocent or illusion. Magic the Gathering is a card game, and I would sit down with some playing cards and somebody else. Obviously, it's Magic the Gathering cards, though, not regular playing cards. And there's magic, I mean, there's colorful symbols on it, and each one has some words next to it. And I've got to match my color red up with your color red, and we do battle. That's not magic. That's not doing a ritual or a spell or anything like that. The danger in the game is that if you're playing with people that are, say, Wiccan or Satanic, either one, now the Wiccan people would not be doing things intentionally to hurt you because they think that all the magic they're doing is for healing or light magic or to do good works. And they don't believe in Satan or demons, devils, evil spirits, God or Satan, and any of that stuff. They don't believe it, but just because they don't believe it doesn't make it not real. So when they're blessing their stuff, they're actually cursing their stuff. And then if you're touching any of their stuff, then this curse could attach to you. Satanists as well will bless their cards, but they're cursing their cards. And if you're touching that stuff and you're playing a game, you have the intention of doing magic, but you're playing the game, so the game is innocent on a certain level. The game itself is innocent, but the intention of the person you're playing with, what is their intention? And because you don't know that, you don't know what they're into, they could be bringing demonic things to the game. And therein lies the danger to you because you're there, you're playing this game. You could get demonic attachment because of this. Now, just because you happen to decide maybe you find a priest somewhere that would bless your deck of cards, that still doesn't alleviate whatever demonic attachment is attached to the other person's cards. And people that come to play these games at some of the tournaments, people are open with their magic or with their Satanism or with their Wiccan magic. People come in and they're wearing pentagrams or inverted pentagrams. Just in case you don't know the difference, pentagram is 1 point up, inverted pentagram is 2 points up. 1 point up is generally a Wiccan, 2 points up is generally a Satanist. I mean, if you want to avoid that person, but that doesn't guarantee you that just because somebody is satanic doesn't mean that they're wearing satanic jewelry or a satanic t-shirt or anything that would identify who they are or what they are. And remember that Satan was a liar and a murderer from the beginning, so the people that follow him as well are not going to tell you the truth. All right, so I hope this answered the questions of the people that ask. I mean, if you have, you want to play with your friend and both of you are Catholic and you have good discernment and you know that going, through the Bible, there's like 30 places in the Bible that warn you not to do magical things, and you've seen my warnings on Harry Potter, and you're not going to go off and try and do real magic, that this game does not tempt you to go do something like that, then have fun with it. But if you don't fall into those exact parameters, don't let your child play it because they're going to think, well, magic is okay here, so why can't I go off and do Harry Potter spells? Why can't I go get a satanic Bible and see what's in there? Why can't I go buy the Necronomicon or Necronomicon 2 because they both are chock full of spells? Why can't I do that kind of stuff? So it'd just be easier to not tempt them with something that could lead them down a path of destruction or put them in a bad place of mortal sin. But if you've got the discernment, you can do it, then go ahead. It's a fun game, but just be careful. All right? God bless you. Have a good night.